Hey guys, it's Hink here. Today I want to touch on a topic that typically gets underreported about. It's basically your testicular health, or you know, the health and well-being of your nuts. And so there's actually quite a bit of things that can go wrong and quite a bit of things that need paying attention to when you're doing PE. And so that's what we're going to talk about today. Let's get right into it. So first of all, we got to talk about the anatomy. And so I'll put up a diagram here first of basically an in-depth version of what we call your spermatic cord. And you know, you have your cords that go down and they go from your basically your lower abdomen into your actual scrotum, and it holds several important things. So you have your spermatic cord, which is basically the outer sheath. Then you have your pampiniform plexus, which is just like the venous plexus in that area. Testicular artery, your cremaster muscle. You know, when your like nuts will like go up and down, that's your cremaster muscle doing that, for anybody who cares, a nerd like me. Then you have your vas deferens that actually carries the semen or the sperm out of your testicles into you basically and out of your penis. Then of course you have the testicle itself. And so if you look on this second view here, which I'll put up, you can see kind of side by side how the spermatic cord runs from your basically your inguinal canal, your groin, and runs down on either side into your testicles. Now that we have that out of the way, well, you know, how can it go wrong? Well, there's a couple of different things that can go wrong. So the first thing we're going to talk about is something that's called a hydrocele. And so in your testicles, you have a sheath that's around your testicles. You can actually accumulate fluid in that area. And so I'll put up a picture here, which you can see. If you're not aware, or you know, sometimes it's just a congenital, meaning you were born with an abnormality where you can have actual fluid accumulate. And sometimes it can actually affect your overall testicular health and fertility. It's usually present in babies, but actually with injury or inflammation, this can occur. And so you need to check for this. There's something that's called a varicocele. And so this is when, you know, that pampiniform plexus of veins that's in your spermatic cord going down into your scrotum. So that's when the valves that are normally supposed to get the blood out of there basically doesn't work, and you just have this accumulation of fluid, particularly venous blood, that stays in that pampiniform plexus of veins. It's kind of like described as feeling like a bag of worms inside your scrotum. These two things are actually the hydrocele and the varicocele are the two reasons why I think nobody should ever pump their testicles. I can't believe that guys are like throwing their dicks in these pumps and pumping it up, because you can accumulate a hydrocele and you can accumulate a varicocele, especially the varicocele. This is also why I personally don't like when I see guys that put cock rings basically behind their cock and behind their balls all the way at the base, because when you have that obstruction, you are obstructing that venous outflow, putting yourself potentially at risk of having a varicocele. And then also, when we are talking about the varicocele, any type of structure, really any of these testicular abnormalities can occur, because you actually have compression of the spermatic cord when you're using a device like a pump, like your hand, like an extender base. Some of these all day stretchers, the bases are like on the penis. And so anyways, that's something that can occur, and I'll get into that a little bit later. Then there's also something that's called epididymitis. And so you have your testicle, and there's something called the epididymis. I don't know why I'm using my hand when I can put up a picture right there. The epididymis is just kind of like this little channel of chamber that can help with the spermatic flow. And you can actually have inflammation of that epididymis along the testicle, and it can be quite painful. Usually it's from something like a sexually transmitted disease, a bacteria, tuberculosis, for example. But chronic inflammation with something that we do in PE could also cause it. You can have fertility issues, guys. If, you know, especially if you're pumping your balls all the time and you actually create a varicocele, and the varicocele is so big to the point where it's impacting your arterial blood to the testicles, you can have hypoxia leading to fertility changes, even potentially decreased testosterone. And so the last thing that can happen is something that's called an inguinal hernia. And so I'll put up a picture here, but there's something, so in your inguinal canal, your groin, there's something that's actually called the processus vaginalis. So we all start off as women, okay? This is not political. I don't care how the fuck you identify or whatever, any of that. But embryologically speaking, we all have ovaries in our, basically in our abdominal cavity. And then as you develop embryologically, if you're destined to be a male, at least genotypically speaking, your testicles actually start to develop, and they pass through your inguinal canal, and it's called the processus vaginalis, and then they descend into your actual scrotum. If they don't descend properly through that processus vaginalis and it remains open, you can have a little loop of bowel, as demonstrated in that picture, that comes through down into your scrotum, and that's called an inguinal canal. Hernia, okay? And sort of an inguinal hernia. And so you need to be aware of that, because if you have a hernia there and then you are putting on, let's say, a pump, and that pump is putting negative pressure on your bowel, you can actually suck bowel further down, and that could make your hernia worse, okay? And so what are the symptoms of a problem? Well, first of all, it's pain. So if you're putting on a pump, right, and you're pumping and it's putting all that pressure back across your scrotum because it's underneath your penis, and you start having this dull ache, well, it's probably because you're compressing the spermatic cord. It could be hypoxic changes. It could be just pain from all the pressure on that area. And so you need to be aware of that. You can actually have a palpable mass in the scrotum, whether it be a varicocele or hydrocele. You can actually have different sized testicles or even infertility. So once again, why do we care? Things like pumping, an extender base, even some sort of, if you're doing manual stretches and you put one hand along your base and you're pulling with the other hand, that hand right there can put pressure on the actual spermatic cord and cause pressure changes to it, some of these same injuries that we're talking about. So what can you do to prevent these things? Well, take frequent breaks. I really don't like any kind of PE set that takes longer than honestly about 15 to 20 minutes. For me personally, I limit all of my sets to less than 10 minutes. But if you are having a extender in place and it's pressing back along your spermatic cord and you leave it there for an hour and you do a set, you know, it's hard to say what kind of hypoxic changes that can occur. Hypoxia meaning oxygen deprivation to your spermatic cord, to your testicles. And so over time, this could potentially lead to problems. So take frequent breaks. If you're in any way concerned, get sperm checks, okay, or even your testosterone checks. One thing that you can do is actually when you put on your pump, okay, you put on your pump on the base, if you actually take your testicles before you start creating negative pressure and pull down as far as you can actually remove any kind of bunching up of the spermatic cord, limit your chance of actually trying to like suck up a testicle into there, and just limit the overall pressure on that spermatic cord. So make sure you do that. Very importantly, examine your nuts on a regular basis. For example, I was concerned I started developing a little hard area on my testicles, and it's actually just my normal anatomy. It's actually my epididymis that I was feeling that, you know, I just never felt for, but I started having some pain. I started to get worried. So make sure you know what's normal and what's not. If you're worried about something, go see a doctor. This is something that I don't think doctors will miss because they're very up to date on testicular issues, testicular problems. So go see a doctor and just don't pump your balls, guys. I've said it before, but I strongly advise you against pumping your balls for so many clear medical reasons. Anyways, guys, just a shorter video today. I hope this helps. Happy holidays to any of those celebrating. Happy New Year, guys. Appreciate the support. Check out Leviathan Supps for our Vigor supplement, citrulline-based, rock-hard erections. It can help with PE. Check out my Patreon if you need any kind of coaching or anything like that. Until next time, peace.